Welcome to organic chemistry, where questions like, where do you keep your chloroform, are no longer suspicious.
Never trust an organic chemist. You ever look at macaroni and cheese and realize you are lucky because no one has tried to eat you?
Up here, are you okay?
Oh, you know, the usual. I'm actually pretty happy. People make fun of creepypasta titles being too descriptive, like, I went hiking with my class and it didn't end well. Or something's living in my grandma's basement. Or, I'm never taking a job on Craigslist again. But for someone with zero attention span, descriptive titles like that are a hell of a lot more eye-catching and attention-grabbing than some poetic one- or two-word title that doesn't even hint at what the story is about. For example, creepypasta title, Red Curtains. What does that even mean? I'm so bored. Meh. Next title. Every house on my block got a new antenna last night. Me, immediately riveted, needs to know what happened or else I will die. Oh my god. Who put them there? What are they doing there? What did they come from? What? And a new title. The real reason Silly Putty isn't available for Prime 2-day shipping. Does this not strike instant curiosity into your heart? I was recently told to Google the official bird of Redondo Beach. This has improved my quality of life immensely. It is the Goodyear blimp. Adopted in 1983. Beautiful. Don't judge a book by its cover should be updated to don't judge a book by its movie. Meanwhile, the Percy Jackson fandom. I overheard these two guys in the hallway of my school. One of them was like, you always look hot, dude. No homo, though. And then 5 seconds later, he yelled, psych! And then slapped the other dude's ass.
Aw, imagine your OTP.
Today is going to happen. Are you?
Is this a threat?
Definitely a threat. Today I learned a new color. Eigengrau is a shade of gray that we all can see, but never knew what it was called. The color is visible when you open your eyes in a pitch black room. All you need to do is find the darkest room in your house, walk in, close your eyes for a minute, open them, and you will see it.
Oh, 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 you won't trick me, demon!
Oh yes, I have a new color in my wine cellar. Come down and take a look.
Ah, oh, that's a golden tag right there. Ben and Jerry's is a dangerous ice cream. Capitalizes on the evolutionary human instinct to dig for chunks. And before you know it, half the pint is gone. Wait, people sleep with their doors closed?
Yo, if growing up in really old New England houses has taught me anything, it's that you have to sleep with the doors closed so that the ghosts that roam the rest of your house won't disturb you. I had it up to here with you, Elizabeth!
You know, the phrase, no matter skill will protect you from the sheer luck of a chronic dumbass, popped into my head. And if that ain't a big mood trademark, I don't know what is.
Dungeons and Dragons, a summary. Okay, for real, kids who grew up with these room plus bathroom combinations don't know how good they had it. I had an entire floor to myself.
And then there's this asshole! Today I learned Pepsi was originally called Brad's Drink.
Still is. Now I'm going to change my name to get some Pepsi. Now it's my drink.
Gaud! Two words. Stingray skeletons.
Oh, my stars and garters! How have we been sleeping on ocean skeletons? We need to awake the ocean skeleton fandom. I mean, what unholy... This is a pufferfish skeleton! This is a butterfly fish skeleton! This is a moorfish idol skeleton! AKA the sexy fish from Finding Nemo.
Yo, check out a Mola Mola skeleton.
This makes me inexpressibly angry. I'm gonna throw a damn chair!
Are we ignoring the fact that Gaud called Gil sexy?
Judge all you want. But the fact remains, you knew exactly which fish I was talking about. You may not like it, but I said sexy fish, and that's where your brain went! We both have to live with our sins.
I hate it when you're right.
Do you honestly think I enjoy it? I hate it!